In this video, we'll discuss style palettes, what they are, how to use them, and how to create your own. To begin with, let's discuss what a style palette is. A style palette is a collection of properties that can be applied to all relevant items in the house at one time. The objects it can contain are rooms, base, wall, and full-height cabinets, custom countertops and backsplashes, interior and exterior hinge doors. Note, style palettes will not affect other door types. And windows. Style palettes can be used in a variety of situations. The most common would be to show a client several different design options for their home. So let's take a look at this in action. I'm going to open a finished plan and open this saved camera view by double-clicking on it. Style palettes are stored in the library. So I'm going to open my library catalog and scroll to the bonus catalog I've downloaded from our website of different style palettes. If I click on the folder, I can see a preview of the options. I'll select one. And notice that when I drag my cursor into the camera view, it changes to a spray can. With the style palette selected, down in my edit toolbar, I have some scoping options. I can apply the style palette to one object at a time, to an entire room, the entire floor, or even plan at once. I'm going to select a room since we're going to focus on the kitchen for today's video. So if I click inside the room, notice what changes. The countertop and backsplash materials, the flooring and ceiling materials, the cabinet door and drawer styles, and hardware. Now I'll select another in the library and place it. And now another. You can see the effect that this has each time. Now let's look a little deeper into what this is actually doing within the plan. I'm going to select a style palette and choose to apply it plan-wide this time. Notice how it changed the flooring in the adjoining rooms as well, even though it did not have the same flooring material as the room we selected. The same goes for the door styles. When applying a style palette, it is not seeking out like objects in the same way as the object eyedropper or material eyedropper. It will paint the selected style onto every relevant object in the plan indiscriminately. So we want to be careful when applying a palette plan-wide or floor-wide, lest we replace materials or objects in the plan we didn't intend to. It is recommended that before you use style palettes, you do a save as of the plan. That will create a copy of it, maintaining the original as is. You can take the copied plan to your client, show the options, and once the client has decided on a style, you can go and apply that style one room at a time. So now let's go through the process of creating a style palette. I'm going to exit out of this plan without saving my changes and open it up again, then reopen my camera view. There are three ways we can create a style palette. First, we can select any object in the plan that can be used in a style palette. I'll select the room to start with. And in the Edit toolbar, you'll find the options Add to Style Palette. This opens a dialog asking if we want to create a new style palette or add to an existing one. In this instance, I'm going to create new. I'll have to give it a name. You'll want to be fairly descriptive. So when you go to use the palette, you'll know what you're applying. Then I could just go through and add each object to the palette. This will grab the default object set in the plan. So if your defaults match the style palette you're creating, you can just go down the list and add all the items you want to be present in this palette. Otherwise, you can select OK, then choose each item in turn, select Add to Style Palette, this time choosing Existing, and select the palette you just created. If we add an item like this appliance cabinet without meaning to, we can either delete it and add a different base cabinet in the plan, or use Open Object to change the cabinet settings. The second way to create a new style palette is to right-click on the user catalog and then select New, then Style Palette. This will open up a blank palette for you to begin adding items, just like we did before. Then when you choose an item, such as a base cabinet, it will immediately open up the specification with your default cabinet for your current plan, which you can then modify. The third way to create a new style palette is to copy an existing one. I'm going to copy one from the bonus catalog we were looking at before. Once I find one, I'll right-click to copy it, and then scroll down to my user catalog and right-click on the folder, then select Paste. Now I'm going to right-click on the newly copied style palette and select Open Object. I can open each object in turn to edit its specification or add and delete objects that aren't relevant to the palette I'm creating. Just like with all objects, you cannot directly edit style palettes in the bonus catalog. So if you want to edit one of the existing palettes, you'll want to copy them to your user catalog first. One thing we want to pay close attention to when creating and using style palettes is the Set Properties option. This will allow us to widen or narrow the scope of what portions of each object we're going to apply to the plan. If I select all the properties to apply, let's see how this will affect my plan. I'm going to go back to my plan view so we can see this most effectively. When I click to place this palette plan-wide, notice how every single base cabinet in my plan is now a 24-inch wide cabinet with a double door. This includes the base cabinet I had altered to be a fireplace seat, and the ones I had made into bookcases or an entertainment center. So I'm going to undo that, and let's open the style palette again, and take another look at those set properties. When using set properties, we almost never want to apply the width, height, or depth. I'm going to clear all and select only the properties I'd like to apply, which in this case are the box material, the box interior material, the door drawer material, the door handle style, the door style, the drawer handle style, the drawer style, and the toe kick material. Everything not selected will maintain the property already set in the plan I'm applying the palette to. Now if we reapply it with the correct property set, when we go back to the plan view, we can see that the size of the objects remain as they were drawn. Style palettes are a great way to easily, in real time, show the various style options for a plan.